All right, here we go.
Here we go. Right, what do we got?
We go.
What do we got?
Oh, boy.
Oh, Teddy Goodz.
Teddy Goodz coming to the ring.
Look at him dance.
Woo! Teddy looks like he's having a good time already.
Getting the crowd fired up.
Fired right up. Giving high fives to everybody he can. Women, children, babies.
Making his way outside the ring into the
corner.
Oh,
Teddy Goodz. Teddy Goodz just strutting it out.
It's a good time, Teddy Goodz.
It is. His opponent, Sully Banger, coming to the ring. Crowd favorite here in Providence, Rhode Island.
Look at the crowd go. They are just cheering Sully nonstop.
The crowd is well behind Sully. Oh, we've got some air guitar going on. A handshake.
A handshake. Good sport.
Nicely done. A nice handshake. Nice handshake to start it off. The crowd is right away
Ladies
into
and
it.
Gentlemen, thanks for joining us tonight for the first match of the evening from New Bedford, Massachusetts at 204 pounds. Give it up for Teddy Goodz! And his opponent, weighing in at 220 pounds, Providence, Rhode Island's own Sully Banger!
Tony P, the referee for tonight.
Tony P, a veteran referee in the ring here.
He's checking
See
the boots.
Tony P.
Checking the boots.
All right. They are going to town, locking up.
Oh, locking up already.
Sully Banger with a side headlock here. Teddy Goodz trying to get out. Cannot do so.
Oop,
up against the rope,
the rope,
bounces him off.
Shoulder tackle by Sully.
Sully right away getting the crowd into this. Teddy Goodz almost shocked at the power of Sully Banger.
People always underestimating the power of the Irish.
That's right. Crowd already all over Teddy Goodz. Oh boy. Sully Banger talking to the crowd. Talking some smack.
Teddy Goodz calling a timeout.
Angela, can we please start this off right with a little crowd participation? Come on.
Oh boy, Teddy Goodz calling for crowd participation. Oh boy.
Let's get this crowd going here. Let's
oh,
clap, people.
Man.
Let's clap.
Getting the crowd right into it. I thought the crowd was into it. I don't know what the stall was, but...
Oh, now the crowd's into it.
Yeah. Teddy Goodz with the headlock now. Bounces him off.
Ooh! Shoulder tackle by
Teddy
Goodz.
Shoulder tackle. Returning the favor to Sully Banger.
Oh, wrist lock.
Ooh, twisting the arm here.
Oh, Sully's getting a reversal.
Sully reverses it.
Teddy Goodz rolling through. Still not able to break it. Oh, using the foot. Oh, pulls Sully down.
Excellent reversal by Teddy Goodz.
Oh, nice reversal by Sully Banger there into a side headlock. Into the corner.
Pushes him back in the corner.
Oh, he's got a handful of hair, Johnny. He's got a handful of
hair.
Hey,
you do what you can to do to win here.
Oh, reversal by Sully. Into the corner. Oh.
Backs him off.
Teddy Goodz, too quick.
Teddy Goodz calling for a little timeout here. Needs a little break. Circling each other again. Going to start off the grapple here. Ooh.
Was Teddy Goodz just mocking me there?
Just mocking the crowd here.
Oh.
Scoops him up for the pin. Only a one count this early in the match.
Ooh, hammerlock into a side headlock.
A lot of technical wrestling here from these two in the early going.
Hip toss. Oh.
Got a head scissor.
Teddy Goodz with Sully Banger and a head scissors, trying to cut off the air to his brain.
Oh, Sully gets out of it.
Sully with it. Sully back with control. Oh, Teddy Goodz pushes him into the corner.
Oh, thought we were going to have a clean break there. Irish whip. Sully showing some athleticism.
Oh, boot to the gut.
I didn't mean to kick him. I was simply showing caution.
Explaining himself to the crowd, Teddy Goodz.
He did not mean to kick him in the midsection. Right in the tiger.
Nope. Going to shake his hand, luring him in almost. Almost.
Sully, I wouldn't do it.
Sully contemplating here. Checking out the knee. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Whoa. We don't need any of that on this stage.
Keep those trunks right where they need to be.
Teddy Goodz does not need to explain himself any further. Going for the handshake.
Oh, the handshake. Oh! Chop right to the mush.
A chop right to the throat.
Oh.
The crowd is just erupting in boos. Never trust a man named Teddy.
Oh,
Sully banger right in the
hard
corner.
Hard into the turnbuckle.
Pushing him away now.
Oh, right
on the back. The crowd chanting for Sully here to get some kind of offense. Teddy Goodz getting distracted by the crowd. That's all it took. Sully gets one in, but Teddy Goodz returns the favor all over him. Going for the pin. Only a
Sully
two count.
With a kick out. Teddy Goodz got a hold of the hair.
Teddy with the chin lock here.
Grinding Sully in the mat. Got a handful of hair. Back two on the ref.
Come on, ref. You got to see that. Come on. Sully trying to punch out of it.
Nice forearm to the face. Oh, that.
That one connected. Oh, knee. Oh. Goes low with the knee. Sully banger goes down. Going for the pin. A two count. Only two. Stretching him out. Oh, look at this maneuver.
Wow.
Look at this maneuver.
I don't know what this is called, but
I've never seen anything like this.
Sully's arms are pinned behind him. Teddy Goodz sitting behind him. It looks extremely painful.
Trying to roll him over. Looked like
he was. Oh, now he's getting the arm. He's going to go for the cross arm breaker. Oh, Sully's fighting it. Fighting. Oh, took a shot to the gut.
Teddy Goodz picking him up now. Little Irish whip into the corner.
Hard into the corner.
Gonna go coast to coast here.
Right into the turnbuckle. Hard.
Sully's back is taking a beating in this match. A little cheap shot from Teddy Goodz.
Referee's checking to see if Sully wants to quit. Making their way back to the feet.
Sully's getting up here, trying to break the hold. Oh, some forearms.
Sully with a left hand.
Swings wildly and misses. Teddy Goodz connects, though. Wildly again. Teddy Goodz.
Backhanded chop across the chest.
Teddy Goodz with these counter punches. Going for the fisherman's.
Fisherman's suplex.
Sully banger. Fisherman suplex
the
is
Sully
no joke.
Fisherman suplex.
The Sully fisherman suplex. No joke. Teddy Goodz looks devastated.
Sully
all
needs
that
to get
momentum.
Up and try to make a cover here.
All that momentum lost on Teddy Goodz. Teddy looks like he's going to be the first to get up here, though, after taking
back
that.
Back down. He's resting in the corner. Sully's up to one leg.
Sully's up to his feet first.
I think he's going to do the Sully Splash.
Planning. Oh.
Back
into the corner.
Into the corner.
Teddy Goodz resting in the other corner, the opposite corner. Here comes Sully. Oh, another one.
Oh, did you hear the ring?
That one had some impact. Sully thinking, what do you want to do next? Bouncing him off the ropes. Oh, trips him up.
Oh, he
trips him up.
Caught in the apron.
Uh-oh, Teddy Goodz looks injured.
Ooh, Sully needs to capitalize here. Teddy Goodz seems to have injured
Sully
his
going
foot.
Sully going up top, ladies and gentlemen. You don't see this very often.
Oh, no.
Sully going up top. Not much clearance. Oh! The shoulder tackle.
Diving shoulder tackle off the top rope.
Oh,
the kick out.
That was a close call.
It was close. Very, very close. Sully tried to capitalize with that diving shoulder tackle off
Teddy
the top
Goodz
rope.
Almost went out
this
there.
This is a short building. He was could, up there.
He
yeah.
could have clipped his head.
He could have hit a light. There's an I-beam right there.
Right.
Sully working Teddy into the corner. Whips him into the opposite corner. Catches his foot. Oh, Insiguri.
Insiguri kick. Sully goes down like a ton of bricks.
Teddy Goodz with the cover. Oh,
only
just
a, two count.
Two count.
Two count again. This Sully banger is resilient. He will not go away.
He's like the Energizer Bunny, John, just less pink.
Less pink?
Well, that's...
I don't know after this match.
Less fluffy.
Right. Teddy Goodz, John at the official here. Tony P. trying to explain himself.
Sully's coming in.
Oh, the schoolboy.
Oh, schoolboy. Roll up.
Oh, gets a two count.
DDT. Oh, DDT.
A Sully DDT.
Oh, with the kick out. That was 2 3/4.
That was so close.
That was a beautiful DDT to the sitting. Teddy Goodz.
Yeah, that had some impact. Holy cow. Both men giving it their all tonight.
Sully looks to be making it to his feet first here. Oh, they're sizing each other up.
Sully's up, pulls Teddy up. Calling his move. I don't know if that was the smartest idea. Whoa.
Oh, fireman's carry.
Fireman's carry. Got him on the shoulders. Teddy frantically trying to get out.
Oh, spinning him. Airplane spin.
Oh, knee to the face.
High knee
to
by
Sully
Teddy
Banner.
Goodz. Off the ropes.
Yes. He's got him up again. Got him up again.
Gary.
Some elbows gets Teddy out of it.
Oh,
a backstabber.
Backstabber.
Backstabber from Teddy Goodz. And
that is all she wrote.
All she wrote, folks. For Sully Banger.
In his hometown.
Teddy Goodz takes home the victory. Looks like his ankle is still injured. Really playing it up.
Oh, Sully's just
oh, now he's jawing
devastated.
At the crowd. Pointing at the crowd, mocking them almost. What happened to that handshake at the beginning of the match?
Oh, all sportsmanship went right out the window, John.
It went out the window awfully fast. Still, though, a great performance by Sully Banger, as always. He took a ton of punishment in that fight. Teddy Goodz, though, hanging around. The two friends.
They're gonna shake hands. They're gonna shake hands. Let's see some sportsmanship here.
This is nice. I don't know though. I don't know if Sully can still trust him. Shaking hands. All good. Oh! Sully!
Sully did a stone cold
Sully,
cutter!
The Sully cutter all over Teddy Goodz. The crowd
the Sully
loves
cutter
it.
After the handshake. Oh, returning the favor.
Sully Banger's
Sully
turn
Banger.
To cheap
Banger.
Shot Teddy Goodz.
Leaving the ring. Leaving Teddy Goodz in a heat.
He may have lost, but he went out on top after. Teddy Goodz still wobbly, trying to find his way back to the locker room. Checking his teeth, making sure they're all there.
It's a devastating maneuver, John.
It's a devastating maneuver. Math the band playing. That was a hell of a match. Way to kick things off.
Great match to start the night.
That is what live prob wrestling is all about right there, folks.
This crowd is into it.
This crowd is very into it. here we go. We got Asana coming out. Asana, she's the suplex sweetheart.
The suplex sweetheart, Asana, coming out to the ring.
She's got devastating suplexes, and she is very proud of them. She's trained by JT Dunn, so you know she's a hard hitter. This is going to be an interesting matchup, folks. We got Delmi Exo coming out here. One third of the Sea Stars. She's dynamite.
Dynamite, look at her.
Delmi Exo here from Planet Exo. The crowd loving Delmi.
Ashley Vox on her way out.
Ashley Vox coming to the ring. Another one third of the Sea Stars. She's from the lost city of Atlantis, folks. And she's here tonight to put on a show.
She's an actual mermaid, John. She's an actual mermaid.
Very much so. The crowd is already into this. They are loving every second of this right now. Coming out next to round out the Sea Stars, we've got Jocelyn. She's Jocelyn. The friendly shark, ladies friendly and gentlemen.
Shark. She's an actual shark.
She's an actual shark. Talk about a lot of fun. Look at this young lady.
She's not an actual shark. She's just a girl with teeth. Very
the crowd
sharp
is
teeth.
Going ballistic for Jocelyn. The crowd is just swimming with Sea Star fans tonight.
Yes.
Ashley Vox getting a great reaction here tonight.
From the Ocean State at 135 pounds, it's Jocelyn!
Oh, the crowd loving Jocelyn.
Loving Jocelyn. There's no way she's 135 pounds.
At 135 pounds, it's Delmi Exo!
Delmi Exo from the Planet Exo.
That's right.
Manny Souza.
Manny Souza going to be the official in this one. He's going to have his hands full. Manny Sears is going to be in deep water here in this one. Catching these fish puns?
He might be another little over his head.
Oh, there we go. All right, this is going to be an interesting dynamic. We got to three on one here with the Sea Stars.
But we respect the other competitors, so we're going to have a fair fight tonight, all right?
Explaining themselves, fair fight tonight.
Handshakes all around.
Handshakes all around. They're going to, looks like they're going to square it all off. Sea Star's not going to join up and take on Isana.
A four-way test of strength?
Oh!
And
they double-crossed her.
Oh, they all kicked Isana.
Oh, man, they are going to town on Isana right from the get-go.
Oh, Shades.
Going for the powerbomb.
Shades of the Shield.
Shades of the Shield, triple powerbomb down on Isana. Oh. Ashley, though, stops the count.
Jocelyn was going to get the pin there.
Jocelyn was going to get the pin. Oh, man. They are arguing amongst themselves.
Oh,
the Sea Stars.
Ashley sneaks in for the pin.
What are you doing?
Sea Stars can't get it together.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is already personal.
Jawing at each other.
Exo
goes for the pin. But again, it's broken up by the other members of the Sea Stars.
Asana rolling out of the ring.
Asana taking her time. She's got to get out of there.
Let these girls fight it out amongst
exactly.
themselves.
It's a 3-on-1. Oh.
Oh, Del Mi Exo
just chops and forearms and chops and forearms and chops and forearms. It's chops and forearms everywhere, folks. She is wrecking her Sea Star sisters.
And when I come back, we all better be friends again.
Oh, drop
oh, double,
kick.
Double drop kicks. Cross body block. Jocelyn went for the pin, only got a one count on Ashley.
Oh
a kick to the gut. Isana coming up by our table here.
Working her way back in the ring. Whoa!
Whoa!
Almost in my lap, John.
Almost in your lap, buddy. Oh, the hair pulling by Ashley. A lot of smack talk here from the Sea Stars to each other. Oh, got her up on the shoulders here.
Jocelyn looks like she's going for a ride.
Oh.
Oh, using Jocelyn.
Oh, wow. Right into the crowd.
Into the crowd. This
that
is a dangerous
man.
Place
that
to be.
That poor man. I show no sympathy for him. Ashley really working on Jocelyn here, pushing her into the corner. Irish whip into the opposite corner. Oh, the swing over.
Blocked.
Oh, kick. High kick. Right to the face. Sneaks through. Rolls her up. Only the two count. Great, great arsenal there from Jocelyn. She does not look like a rookie here tonight.
Oh, right to the midsection.
Ashley. Another one.
Ashley is taking it to her.
Right down.
For the pin. Ashley,
only one count. Isana still out here on the ring down here on the floor, just taking her time, recuperating.
Del Mi Exo knocked off the apron.
Jocelyn looking for some support from the crowd.
She's
getting it.
Forearm right to the chin. Oh,
they are just trading blows here, folks. Oh, a little drop toe hold here. Brings her down.
Oh. The crowd's chanting, bite her.
Crossface here.
Asana
with a kick
ring.
To break it up. Breaks up the submission. She's yelling at her, stop interfering.
Jocelyn's got Ashley up. Oh, dropped her.
Double clothesline from Asana.
Showing the power. Here comes Delmi. Missing.
Swing and a miss.
Oh.
Asana drops her with these clotheslines. Sends her into the corner. Knee right to the midsection. Another one right to the section onto Jocelyn. And one more for Ashley.
Who wants some suplexes, huh?
Calling to the crowd for some suplexes. And here she goes, folks. There's a suplex. There's a suplex right to Vox. She's down and out. Jocelyn. She tries to have her hand at it. And she takes a suplex.
Oh, it's Suplex City, John.
Oh, it is.
It's Suplex City.
Oh, wildly swing from Exo.
Oh,
there's
on
a
her
suplex.
Head. Asana just asserting her dominance in the
she
ring right now.
Suplexing everybody. Playing to the crowd, then goes for the pin. She might have cost herself the win right there by playing to the crowd. Uh-oh. Going outside the ring here. It is just chaos outside the ring. All four members of this match outside the ring trading blows. You got Exo and Isana over there. You got Jocelyn
and Ashley.
And Ashley Vox just tearing it out up here. Oh, right to the apron.
Could you hear that, folks?
Uh-oh, up against the post. Some chops. Oh, Ashley just nailed her hand. Jocelyn, give her
the shark bite.
She's
giving her the shark bite in the arm. She almost ate her tricep.
Back on the other side, you got Isana just really bringing it to Exo. She's got her down with a wrist lock. Exo brings the knee up, though. Head slam right down on the apron.
This is pandemonium.
This is pandemonium. Oh, slams her over to the restroom. A woman was in the restroom.
She had no idea what was
going
on.
The very interactive crowd, folks. Action right close to us here. This ref has to get a handle on this.
I'm not sure which way this is going here.
The official needs to get a handle on this.
Asana rolled into the ring to stop the
count. Oh, my goodness. Outside the ring, still all four members of this.
Uh-oh. Johnny just caught Joslyn in his lap.
Right here. Right in front of us, folks.
Oh, right outside of our announce table.
Right outside of our announce table.
Ashley's putting Joslyn back into the ring.
This is the first time a member of this match has been inside the ring in, I want to say, about 5 minutes now.
Yeah.
It's the longest 10 count I've ever seen.
Ashley's got a net.
Ashley throws the net on him. Wait on Isana and Exo. Joslyn, however, getting back in the ring.
Holy shit. Ashley up on the ropes. Joslyn coming.
Oh, Joslyn!
Spits in her face. Oh, the seawater. It's salty, John.
It's so salty.
Oh,
going for the pin.
Oh, the jackknife.
Joslyn
gets the three count.
Joslyn wins the win. Using the seawater. The crowd going nuts for Joslyn. All because Ashley Box threw the net onto Demi Exo and Isana. They were out of the action. Could not come in and break up the pin for once.
Ashley's still slipping in the seawater. She can't see.
Joslyn capitalizes. Oh, boy. What a match, folks. What a match. You're not going to see anything else like that.
And these girls, I believe they're all friends again.
All four women celebrating in the ring. What a show. High-fiving. Still the power for Isana. A little too much for Delmi Exo. High fives all around.
You know what, guys? I think you really need to remember that you guys are all friends. All right? Can we just get a group hug? I know.
Looks to be a group hug. Ceremony of friendship here.
Isana wants a group hug.
Bringing her in. Oh, boy. Oh, no. Who do we have here?
All good Anthony Greene has just come out.
All good Anthony Greene. And what looks to be the son of Harvey Whippleman.
Oh, the crowd chanting, fuck that guy, to all good Anthony Greene.
This is not a show for kids, folks. The crowd not behind Anthony Greene here. Having technical difficulties over there.
Trying to get the mic to work. Uh-oh.
I don't know what's going
on. Oh, what's
on
going
here?
On over here? He's giving the band fun of the band.
You do not make fun of Math the Band.
Get up.
All good Anthony Greene coming into the ring now. I don't know what's going on here.
I don't know what's going on
this
here.
This is crazy. Not getting the respect that these women deserve at all. All four of these women just put on a hell of a show.
Oh,
and they
the chants are deafening.
This.
The chants are definite.
That was a great match, though, by all four competitors there.
It did not deserve to be interrupted by all good AG over here.
No.
We just need to get the real talent in the ring. And then out of the ring for the microphone to work properly. Hey, what I need right now is for each and every single one of you Providence scumbags to shut your mouth and listen to me.
The band's got an answer for that, folks.
Math, the band does not like this gentleman.
That's pretty good. You guys are pretty ironic. I hear that's the hipster thing to do, right?
Uh-oh, dropping insults to hipsters.
That's a dangerous move in this crowd, folks.
Not going to get you far here in Providence.
All good, AG is a talent.
He is. He's a ton of talent, but the crowd is not behind him here tonight.
Hey, you right there. You want to talk to me, baby angel? You can boo me, but just know that guys like me don't date girls with faces like me.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
All good, Anthony Greene giving it to the crowd here.
There's a girl pointing to her crotch over there.
Holding up a fuck that guy sign.
All right, I have to agree with him there, Johnny.
Wow. Anthony Greene, not a fan of hipsters.
But then again, we live in Maine, and Portland is probably the hipster capital of New England.
True. That's true.
Women's Day.
Oh, I don't like this.
Oh, I don't
like.
Yep, this is about to be sour, folks.
You know, women are treated as equals to men.
Yeah.
There you go. So you know what I said? Equal rights, equal fights, and that's why tonight, all good Anthony Greene is going to be going up against a world-renowned women's wrestler. I've seen her beat women. I've seen her suplex men on their heads.
Is it you?
It's not going to be me.
He's, of course, referencing Bonesaw Jesse Brooks. I would not be
as
poking
flippant.
The bear.
I would not be as flippant with my comments as he is being right now.
You can play your shitty music. Bring out Bonesaw Jesse Brooks.
Calling her out.
Calling her out.
Calling her out.
I would not be doing that at all, AG. She is as tough as they come. She's the self-proclaimed baddest woman on the planet. And I concur, she is a monster. She is going to destroy AG. Look at that face, nothing but business. AG better watch himself tonight, Harmon. He's already off to a bad start. She is not screwing around.
I'm sorry, I'm just speechless.
It's all good.
Bonesaw. Okay, toughest woman in the world. Okay.
Anthony Greene's suit out here just talking mad trash to Jesse Brooks. I would not be messing with Jesse Brooks. She's wrestled for Shimmer. She's wrestled for Women Superstars Uncensored. She is currently the Warriors of Wrestling Tag Champion. Her suplexes are absolutely legit.
All good, Anthony Greene might have bitten off more than he could chew here.
Absolutely. I agree.
AG with a definite height advantage.
Yep, he's got the height advantage. He pushes her right in the corner here.
Oh, patting her on the head.
A clean break, but it's a mocking break as well.
Clear
pats
show
her on the head.
Of disrespect. She
and he's just smiling about it.
Angry.
No smiles here tonight from Jessie Brooks. She is nothing but business.
She looks all business right now.
Yep. The crowd is chanting kick his ass. Again, into the corner. All good.
Picks puts her up on the top rope.
And again,
pats her
on
the
head.
He is probably just going to regret this.
Just poking the bear. Not a wise decision here from all good Anthony Greene. I have a feeling he's going to get what's coming to him tonight. Circling each other. Lock up. She's got him in a side headlock.
She won that collar and elbow tie-up. She's in the side headlock now.
She is just wrenching on AG.
AG right pushing her against the ropes, firing her across the ring. She ducks under, comes back.
AG with the screech. And Bonesaw taps him on his man
curled
bun.
Up like a child.
She ducks under. Oh,
no.
Belly to belly.
Oh, head slap.
Head slap. She's going to be hearing those ears ring. Oh, chop. A chop from hell over to AG.
Oh, right into another one.
AG cannot find the mark on those strikes, but Jessie Brooks is finding her mark. Right on the chest. Oh, another one, a front slap right to the chest. AG is writhing in pain. Reversal. Another miss. Oh, going
oh,
for the suplex. He
going
gets
for
to
a
the
suplex.
Ropes.
He gets to the ropes. Ties himself up on the ropes to escape.
It looked like AG was terrified of that German suplex attempt.
AG is
I would be as well.
Collecting himself outside the ring. I think he realizes he is in a real fight right now.
No doubt about it. Referee backing Jessie Brooks off, letting AG get into the ring.
AG making his way back into the ring.
Pumping himself up.
Oh,
trips
on the rope.
He trips on the ropes.
Kicks the rope. Hurt himself.
Drop toe hold.
Oh.
A little camel clutch action.
Camel clutch.
Involvement here from all good Anthony Greene's suit out there. Stalking her.
Oh,
the punch. Oh, my God. He
connected.
Just
he
rumbled her. She is down.
He is flipping the double bird
just
to the crowd.
The crowd.
Now he's running outside the ring.
Mocking the crowd. AG cannot take this woman lightly. He has to get back in there and finish her off. Little snap mare over.
Oh,
drop kick to the back of the neck. Goes for the pin. Only a one count.
One count?
Only a one count. How tough is Jessie Brooks? She got she kicked out at one on that. If you don't think this match is important to Jessie Brooks, then you got another thing coming. She kicked out at one after all of that. Into the corner.
So hard into the turnbuckle.
That was a tough one. She's favoring her lower back here, folks. While AG gets a little R&R. Forearm to the back. AG's trying to stay on her.
The crowd.
Oh.
Not a fan of
AG's
man bun.
The crowd is not a fan of the man bun, which is surprising to me being in Providence. Tightening it up, making sure it's all tight over there. Jessie Brooks, though, she's creeping back. Takes a forearm right to the face.
I don't know how much more of this she can take.
Off the ropes. Oh, over the top. Oh. The crowd gets a shot of the ass of AG. The crowd is writhing here in visual pain. This is awful.
It's a Sunday, folks.
AG,
we can't be looking at
pull
this.
Those things up, my man. Jesse Brooks into the corner, takes a shot. AG unaware of his pants down, it seems.
Looks like he shaves.
It was Brazilian week here in Providence. Putting the boots to Jesse Brooks is all good, Anthony Greene. Still jawing at the crowd.
Lifting her up, going for the slam.
Oh, letting the blood go to her head and then down for the body slam.
Standing on her for the pin.
Chris Jericho
style. Just a one count.
Again, just a one count. He hasn't got her down for a two count yet.
Oh,
not even a one count.
Oh,
and the,
man.
Just the snarl look from Jesse Brooks up at all good Anthony Greene. Pushes her into the corner. Oh, looking for some chops. Oh, man. That did not go over well.
No.
She looked pissed. No. Oh, no. No reaction from Jesse Brooks. Bonesaw is
no
just
sell.
Ruthless. Not having it at all, folks.
Coming out of the corner.
Oh! Gives it, returns the favor with some chops.
Just brutal.
Brutal. Rapid fire now from Brooks to AG. This is incredible. Appropriately getting the holy shit chant from the crowd. Into the corner.
Oh, wow.
Amazing clothesline into the corner.
AG is on the bottom rope trying to collect himself.
She's stalking him. Oh, elbow to the face though. Some forearms from AG. The reversal. Suplex.
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's suplex time. That's what I'm talking about. Those suplexes are legit. Suplex. Oh, here we go. Spins into
suplex.
Another one. She's hooking the leg. Going for a third one. Three Amigo style. Nope.
Oh,
another
into
suplex.
The bridge.
Into the bridge.
Oh,
only
two
a two count.
Count.
She's helping Anthony Greene up. Anthony Greene can't even get up. A little flip here. Armbar. Going for the armbar.
He's holding his hands together. He's not letting her get a good grip on that arm.
There's that jiu-jitsu background from Jesse Brooks. AG gets to the ropes. Those long legs, height advantage of AG really helping him out there. Get to the ropes. He's trying to get out. She's stalking him though.
Pulling him back into the ring. She's got his back.
Oh. Little gut buster there from AG. Oh, the forearm coming off the ropes. Elbow right to Jesse Brooks from AG. They're just trading blows here, folks. Who is going to come out on top? Little front headlock. Little guillotine. Bounces her off the ropes.
Leapfrog.
Oh, the cutter. The cutter from AG onto Jesse Brooks. She kicks out at two. It's two, folks.
Just a two count.
AG is astonished.
He has finished off many a foe with that move.
He cannot believe she kicked out at two. The crowd well behind Bonesaw here, chanting her name. Kick to the gut.
Kick to the gut.
Oh, the roll up.
The roll up.
Only a two count. Bonesaw turns it into an arm bar. She's got to unlock his arms though, Harmon.
Yeah, he's got a grip on his other arm. Rolling over. He's going to pick her up.
Going for maybe a single arm power bomb here. Does he have the power though? Oh, and he breaks the hold, slamming her down. Two.
Oh, she bridges
she
out.
She bridges. Not even a kick out, Harmon, just a bridge. That's some straight
guttural scream.
That's some collegiate grappling wrestling right there. She is just nothing but power. AG with the hair pulling her up. On the shoulders. What's AG going to do with her? Oh, she slaps the old love handle there. Almost into the ref. Oh, Tony P goes down.
Bonesaw right into the referee.
Tony
AG
P.
moved out of the way.
Very smart from AG. He's a crafty vet.
Oh, the straight kick right to the face. There's no referee, though. He can't pin her.
I don't know what AG's going to do here. No official in sight.
Bonesaw, which
clothesline from hell. Spinning AG around. Bonesaw going for the pin, but like we said, no official, nobody to count. Oh, no. Got some interference here.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Who is this man? He's got some powder. He's got some powder in a bag. Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Powder right to the face of AG. Went for Bonesaw. She ducked out of the way.
Oh!
AG goes for a wild blind super kick. Nails
right,
his counterpart.
Right into Rich.
Bonesaw with a forearm and the German suplex into
with
the pin. Tony P's got to get on it. The three count. Bonesaw takes it.
Unbelievable.
The crowd is going nuts for Bonesaw. Jesse Brooks. She just defeated all good Anthony Greene despite constant interference. She gets her hand raised at the end of the day. It does not pay to be sexist here in Providence, Rhode Island, Harmon.
Doesn't pay to cheat either, John.
Jesse Brooks brought it to AG. She is one bad woman. I think her moniker holds up. She is the baddest woman on the planet. She just proved it here tonight against all good Anthony Greene, who is a crafty veteran. All good is, he's on winning streaks all the time. He's undefeated in limitless wrestling, and Jesse Brooks just dominated him. Little pushback here. His suit obviously upset from the super kick. They're going to town here. Just dropping F-bombs left and right, ladies and gentlemen. He's going for the punch. Asking the crowd for support. Oh, it's all a ruse.
They're still friends.
This, much to the crowd's dismay.
This crowd is appalled.
They do not like that. Definitely do not like that here tonight. But you know what? After it's all said and done, Anthony Greene goes home with a loss to Jesse Brooks. What a showing. Jesse Brooks is the real deal, my man. Math the band kicking out the hard jams. Just in time for the next match. Setting up the tag ropes. Gonna be a tag match coming up. I believe we've got Adrenaline Rush versus Middlesex Express. Thank you.
coming out. Look at these sleazeballs.
These guys gotta be the greasiest guys I've ever seen.
Look at those outfits. Are those pink trunks with leopard prints?
Pink trunks with leopard prints.
What's my problem? I gotta be here in front of chunks like you that wish they looked this good.
Already talking smack to the crowd. Coming over here having some fun. They definitely have a look, huh?
Steven Lust and Steven Brody.
Steven Broad.
Sorry, I threw in an extra
eye. Adrenaline rush making their entrance here. These guys are hyped. These guys are all about staying hyped, baby. We got Keith Youngblood and Dangerous Daniel Evans. These guys are digging the music. They're digging the crowd. The crowd's digging them. They've got so much energy.
Keith Youngblood looks like an absolute
Middle
maniac.
Middlesex Express smartly leaves the ring. Crowd loving Adrenaline Rush right now. Math the Band getting a shout out here on the card.
Up next, we got a real special tag team match.
Damn right!
In the Danger Zone. At a combined weight of 440 pounds, Keith Youngblood and Dan Evans are Adrenaline Rush! From Lowell, Massachusetts, weighing in at a combined weight of 420
Middlesex Express.
And 1/8 pounds.
Adrenaline rush out of the ring for their entrance.
He's the buff dad. He looks like a dad.
Those are some very tight Zubas.
I don't think I'd want my dad to wear tights like that. There looks to be a definitive size difference here between the two tag teams.
Only about a foot.
Right? Middlesex Express, they're still jawing at the crowd. Lust up there in the corner just yakking away. Brood coming down. He's clapping his hands. He's trying to get the crowd into it. Trying to get a Middlesex Express chant going here. Crowd just chanting that they suck.
They can't handle it. They can't handle it.
Crowd cannot handle the Middlesex Express.
Adrenaline Rush.
Adrenaline Rush going to give
crowd.
It a shot here. Playing to the crowd.
Crowd loves him. Crowd loves him.
Loves Adrenaline Rush. Youngblood and Evans. Clearly the crowd favorite here. Again, boos erupt for a Middlesex Express. Youngblood and Dangerous Evans going up there again. Oh, but maybe have been one time too many. Middlesex Express.
This match hasn't even started yet, officially.
Giving them the business. Both off the ropes now. Clothesline!
Oh! High backdrop.
A drop kick from Youngblood. A backdrop from Evans. You're right, the bell hasn't even rang yet. Referee trying to get some kind of order here in this match. We need to start this. This thing is pure chaos. The match hasn't even started. Bell finally ringing here. Looks like Youngblood's going to start it off against Lust. Lust already favoring his back. They lock up. Youngblood with the headlock here.
What era would you say that Lust mustache and beard combo come from?
It definitely looks, I want to say Civil War era. I don't know. It looks very dated. I don't see anything sexy about it. Colonial? Colonial, maybe?
Sure. Or, you know, a certain era in the 70s where adult films were popular.
Sure, I could see that. I found a few tapes under my dad's bed with that same exact facial hair.
Did you rewind him back to the exact spot where
I had
started?
Okay. I had to. Yeah. That way he wouldn't know.
Oh, he knew.
Of course he did. The athleticism from Youngblood does not pay off, though. I feel like Youngblood's going to have to rely on his athleticism here. Youngblood's got a parkour background. Parkour. Super athletic. Look at that.
Wow.
Look at that. That's what I'm talking about. That's showing his parkour right there. The arm drag. He's got Lust down. Lust gets to the ropes, though, to break the hold.
He's not very tall, but he made the reach to the rope.
He did. He's just scampering back. He's
looking for the tag. Makes it.
Makes it over to Brood. He's going to show us how it's done, apparently. Drop toe hold from Youngblood. Gets the tag over to Evans. They bounce Brood off the ropes. Oh, there we go. It's a Japanese arm drag, folks.
Oh, the diving neck breaker there. Oh!
A little toss.
Brood is taking it rough over here. Evans just throwing him across the ring. Picking him up as if he was a small child.
Just dead weight here. Just a dead weight suplex. Just tossing him around like he's a rag doll. Evans is a behemoth in there. Clearly has the size advantage of every man over every man here.
Youngblood back in the ring.
Oh boy. Suplex. Oh my goodness. God.
Lust breaks up the pinfall.
Lust breaks it up.
That wasn't so much a kick as it was Evan stepped on his chest from a standing position and rode him down.
Buff Dad over here. What's Buff Dad doing? Why is he over here? Get him out of here. Oh, just causing a distraction. That's why. Evans comes in, tries to break it up.
Middlesex Express sneaking back into the ring from the backside.
He's sneaking over there. Oh, Buff Dad avoids the shot. Oh, double elbows to Youngblood.
Oh! A senton and an elbow.
Going for the pin. A two count. A two count on Youngblood.
Strong kick out, though. Strong kick out.
Yeah, he almost sent Brood across the ring here with that kick out. Just smothering him, working him right back into the corner. Gets the tag into Lust, and they are just stomping a mud hole in him. Oh, my goodness. Youngblood looks helpless over there. He needs to get to his corner. He needs to tag in dangerous Daniel Evans. Again, though, the ref really holding back Evans while Youngblood is just helpless over there. Getting double teamed. Little snap suplex.
Brood with the cover.
Only two, though. Only two. He's reaching for Evans. Can't quite get to him, though. Little chin lock.
Youngblood really needs to get back to his corner to tag in Evans.
It's going to be a long night for Youngblood if he can't make that tag. Oh, knocking
him down
again.
Middlesex Express is using their corner of the ring very effectively.
Great tag team wrestling for the Middlesex Express. This is not their first rodeo, you know what I mean? Oh, blows him a kiss.
Oh,
neck breaker.
Lust for the pin.
Only a two count, though.
Youngblood kicks out.
Almost mocking Evans there, pointing him at him. Trying to get a chant going for Youngblood is Evans. He's got to get Evans in there. He's the fresh man. He's powerful. He's bigger than everybody else in this ring.
Lust is choking Youngblood with the rope. Just sitting on him, taking the wind out of him.
Youngblood is taking a beating in this match.
Braun is now holding him over there. Holding his head
on
the rope.
The ref is distracted again by Evans. Evans is not helping his partner out at all. I mean, he has a valid gripe, folks, but man, he's got to play the numbers game here. Middlesex Express just bringing it to Youngblood. Oh, the disrespect! The disrespect!
Snot rocket on
Evans
from Lust.
If Evans gets in there, though,
he might
want to
get checked out.
Evans has an extremely hard punch. He's got a boxer's background. If he gets in there and gets a hold of Lust, it is lights out. But that's the thing. Youngblood's got to get in there. He's got to get Evans in. Oh, the little slap to the belly. Another one. He's trying to get free here. Catches the kick and a knee. A lifting knee right to the mug of Youngblood. Goes for a zigzag type. Misses. Clothesline. Clothesline from the depths of hell.
Sends Youngblood over his head.
Only a two count. Oh, that was close, folks. Lust cannot believe it. Thought that they had the win in the bag. Look at that. Stepping on the ankle. Won't let him get to the ropes or his tag partner. And he tags in Brood. Just that is great veteran tag team wrestling there from the Middlesex Express. Oh, inches away.
Youngblood,
but Brood brings it back. Oh, and Lust comes over. Takes out Evans. Lance Aguirre, finally an opening for Youngblood, but Evans is nowhere to be found.
Evans is down outside the ring.
Youngblood can't believe it. He's confused. He can't believe it. He's cheering his partner on, telling him to get up.
Evans needs to get up and help his tag partner.
Oh, the opportunity is missed, folks. Youngblood is back on the mat. Brood just
drop-kicked him in the head.
Kick. Oh,
the crossface pin. Oh,
a two count. Only a two count. Brood making the tag to Lust again. Now they are just in unison tonight. What they lack in size and power, what they give up to adrenaline rush, they are making up with just tenacity and experience. You can tell they're just both veterans. And they work as a
very savvy competitor
just
here.
Just savvy.
Very, very savvy.
Whoa, finally! Youngblood reverses. He makes the tag into dangerous Daniel Evans.
Daniel Evans just having his way with
Evans
the Middlesex Express.
Clearing house.
Clothesline. Clothesline.
He's got them both now. Looking to knock some skulls here, and he does. Much to the crowd's delight. Both of them in the corner.
Oh,
clothesline to Lust. Brood over.
Thrown in the Lust.
Oh! That's a low blow, folks. That looks like something that I saw on those videos we were talking about earlier. Power slam. Tossing him around. Evans goes for the pin. Over to I thought it was three.
Lust,
I thought it was going to be three.
Youngblood. Tossing Lust
tosses
out of the ring.
Tosses him out. Looks at Brood.
Oh, Thomas drop.
Spine buster. Youngblood feeling it now. Youngblood is not the legal man, though. Evans is still the legal man.
Sousa's trying to get him out of the ring.
Oh, what is this? Looks like he's going for a people's elbow. He's mimicking The Rock going for the people's elbow.
Oh, my God.
The people's elbows, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't believe that just happened.
Copyright infringement.
Somebody call the gimmick lawyer. Oh!
Lust back in, takes out Youngblood. And he is happy about it. What he doesn't know, though, is that Evans is lurking behind him. Got him down now. Double leg takedown. Puts the leg through. Going for a sharpshooter. Oh, no, though. Look at Brood over there. Brood tuning up the band.
Oh, sweet super chin kick. Music.
Sweet chin music right to the mug of Evans.
Everybody is down right now.
Evans, a former boxer, can definitely take a punch, but that was a boot right to the jaw. Everyone down. Ref at the count of five. Brood over there standing up. Up almost to his feet.
Up to one knee. Brood is up first. Evans falls.
Then Evans. Oh, just some hard strikes all the way around. This is turning into a slugfest. You're not seeing any technical wrestling at this point in the match. It's just slugging. Oh, the reversal.
Oh, wow.
Youngblood with a
discus
spinning
forearm.
Spinning discus forearm. Oh, here we go. Danger zone.
Oh, Buff Dad.
Oh, Buff Dad
that
getting
kick to the
involved.
Face.
A high boot. Oh!
Evans.
There's that punch I was talking about earlier.
The danger punch.
The danger punch.
Brood over the top rope. Blocked by Evans. Got a suplex back into the ring.
Gonna bring him in the hard way. Oh no. Brings him in. Oh!
Lost grabbing his leg. Oh my.
Lost.
Oh no.
Holding the leg down.
Oh, and then super kick.
Then a super kick over to Youngblood.
Super kick Youngblood in the face.
The Middlesex Express just stole that victory.
Oh, it's highway robbery.
Cannot believe it, folks.
They're dragging the Buff Dad back.
Dragging Buff Dad. Lust back into Gloat. Doing a single-handed crutch chop.
Oh, Broad is just gyrating over there. It's disgusting.
It is greasy and gross.
Get these animals
I do not
out of
like
the
it.
Ring.
Not good at all.
I can't believe what I've just seen.
They are just mocking Daniel Evans over there.
Underhanded and dirty.
Cannot believe it, folks. Oh.
Oh, they're making their way out of the ring.
They're
going to
run for it, though. They know that they stole that one.
Adrenaline rush chasing them out of the ring.
Youngblood and Evans are not happy about how that went down.
Here we go, everybody. Here we go, everybody. We're coming back from intermission. Cam Zagami entering the ring.
Cam Zagami's gear looking sweet as ever. That must be that American grit money. American grit. Paying for that sweet gear.
I wish I had some of it.
I know, right?
I watch the show. I feel like you should pay me. I wish I had his hair. I wish I had any hair.
He's got a lot of product in that here, in that hair. Not enough product.
It's a good do.
It's a good do.
Oh, Xavier Bell, X gonna give it to ya.
Cam Zagami's gonna have his hands full with Xavier Bell here tonight.
We've seen Xavier Bell on numerous occasions, and he is a tough opponent for anybody.
Yeah.
Crowd popping big for
People
Xavier
love
Bell.
Xavier Bell anywhere.
His opponent
Oh, this crowd.
Crowd really shitting on Salem, New Hampshire. Crowd already knows that Cam Zagami is a dirtbag. They do not like Cam Zagami. Fruity drinks do make you hungover. So. Harsh words from Cam Zagami over here. The crowd is not digging it.
He is riling the crowd up.
Oh, the fuck this guy chant promptly being thrown at Cam Zagami. Xavier Bell just eating it up.
Oh, Xavier Bell wasting no time hitting Zagami with a dropkick.
Xavier Bell shutting him up with 2 feet to the mouth. Match hasn't even started yet. Has it?
Oh.
Allegedly
it has. Those chops are legendary in these parts.
Xavier Bell notorious for having the hardest chops in the biz. And this crowd loves it. Starting right off with chops.
The match hasn't even started yet. And Cam Zagami's already getting a welt.
The crowd chanting 9 more times. A little throwback to last time Xavier Bell was here and he chopped Danger Kid 10 times in 10 seconds. Enziguri to Cam Zagami. Zagami is stunned. Clothesline over the top rope. Xavier Bell knocks Cam Zagami right out of the ring. Oh, Xavier feeling it. He is feeling it, ladies and gentlemen.
Shaking that booty.
He's going to fly.
He's going to fly.
Over
the
top
rope.
Over the top.
Tope suicida.
Oh, easy there, Mauro. Getting high fives. Chugging a woman's beer. Amazing. He is a crowd favorite.
Hey, that cost
Xavier
her $3.
He throws Zagami back into the ring. The crowd is loving it. Bouncing off the ropes now is Bell.
Oh, the senton.
The big bomb. Gets the 2 count on Zagami.
So this match has officially started now.
It has. Into the corner with authority. Bell, Bell eats an elbow from Zagami. Flips him up over the top rope.
Poke in the eye.
What a cheap shot, a thumb to the eye.
Oh!
Springboard drop kick right to Bell's mug. Bell is rolling around on the outside.
Oh, the crowd is...
Look at the crowd here, folks. They are cheering Bell on. They want him to get up.
Zagami as loud as possible.
Zagami now taunting. Going after him now. Throws him back in. Rolls him in with authority.
Going for the pin.
Only a 2 count. I've seen Xavier Bell. Harmon, you and I both have seen Xavier Bell many a times. It's going to take a hell of a lot more than that to take Bell out. Scoop, power slam there. Whoa, quick little leg drop. Goes for the pin again. 2 count.
Cam Zagami's got to know. These guys have seen each other multiple times.
Cam Zagami just taunting.
It is going to take more than that to put down Xavier Bell.
looks like a crowd he would not want to mess with. They're hearing numbers, folks. Kagami trying to get a chant going. Not going to happen here. Oh, Xavier Bell slipped out. A crafty move by the veteran.
Just hammering him with elbows.
Just forearms and elbows and just nothing but pain towards Zagami.
This is a dangerous spot, Johnny. They're on the apron of the ring. You know, it's the hardest part of the ring.
It's the hardest part. I've heard that once or twice or three times.
Oh, drives Bell into the ring post.
Bell's back's got to be sore after that. He gets rolled into the ring. Zagami going for the pin again. Still only a two. Still only a two count. Now that's just ruthless. Just a cheap, nothing technical about that. Kick to the back. Going back to some chops. Uh-oh. Setting him up for something now. Oh, swinging up for a powerbomb. Powerbomb into the
turnbuckle. Xavier Bell shoots off. Hits him with a lariat.
Turns him
inside out.
He just took that shot, and it was almost like a shot of adrenaline for him. He came out swinging out of the corner and laced Zagami. Both of them down now. They're trying to get up. Referees at the five count.
Zagami climbing the ropes.
Zagami is up. Zagami's up first. Fell to a knee, gets up now. Oh, just elbows from Zagami. Oh, just taunting him. Gives him the finger. Off the ropes goes both men. Oh, and just a double forearm shove from Xavier Bell. Thrice now. Oh, the backdrop.
Backdrop.
From Xavier Bell.
Xavier Bell is finding some power.
Armin Xavier Bell is feeling it right now, wouldn't you say?
Oh, he's getting hot. He's gonna go coast to coast here, corner to corner. Oh, back elbow. Back of the
going
corner.
Going for a second.
Another
one.
Back elbow.
Again, the third.
Three times the charm.
Oh, Zagami is stunned. Neckbreaker. Neck breaker. Just
Bell
a two
gets
pound.
A quick 2 pound.
Xavier Bell joining the crowd. Oh, the
band hits him with a rim shot.
Rim shot from Matt, the band over there. Oh, a little super kick.
Bell eats the short kick.
Bell is on his knees and eats it with the added FU bone from Zagami.
Oh,
my goodness, a rock
bottom.
Oh, just a two count.
Oh, that was a deep cover, too.
Xavier Bell just flooring Zagami with a rock bottom. You don't see that much nowadays.
Zagami might be a slime ball, but he is tough.
He is tough. I mean, you don't get on a show like American Grit without being tough.
You don't become John Cena's best friend.
That's right.
Oh! Suplex into the turnbuckle.
Zagami showing his frustration now.
Letting his emotions get the better of him. Going to try to finish Bell off right now.
There we go. Uh-oh. Zagami between a rock and a hard place right now. Pushed to the outside by Bell.
That looked dangerous.
It did look dangerous. I feared for the fans' lives on that one.
The brick wall is only 3 feet away from the edge of the ring there. He could have easily smashed
his right near
his face.
The group of fans that he was mouthing off to earlier is Zagami. Dangerous swampland out there. Bell going to get him, though. Body slam right
on the edge
apron.
Of the apron.
What did you say earlier about the apron?
It's the hardest part of the ring, Johnny.
It is. And he just took a body slam. Two count.
Zagami kicks out.
Zagami taking all kinds of punishment here.
Stand back,
Oh, Xavier Bell.
Oh, Xavier Bell eats a forearm.
Xavier Bell is grabbing the tights, though. Reels him back in.
Flips him over.
Sagami showing some athleticism.
Sagami lands on his feet, pushes the ref into the corner.
Oh, a cheap shot right to the midsection. Sagami sizing
him up. Referee Souza seems to be okay.
Oh.
I don't think he got all of it.
He definitely did not get all of it. Sagami. Sagami takes home the win.
I guess he got more of it than we thought, Johnny.
I guess he did get more of it than we thought.
I think his foot.
It didn't look like he did, but he got a deep pin on him.
I think his foot slid across Xavier's back and hit him in the back of the head.
That back of the head, I tell you. That's a soft spot. You don't want to get hit there. You know, Cam Sagami, for all his glitz and all his Hollywood-ism, he's a tough dude, and he just showed it here tonight. Still very much into this card tonight. They're enjoying themselves.
Because they're fueled by Narragansett beer.
Narragansett. We're having a few Narragansetts right now.
Hey. Very soothing.
It is. Soothing throat. Tony P making his way back into the ring.
Here's insane Dick Lane has made his way to the ring.
No.
Oh, it's Frat Boy Farva.
Frat Boy Farva, ladies and gentlemen. This guy knows how to have a good time.
He's got his red solo cup in his hand.
Frat Boy Farva in the ring. He looks ready to go. He looks ready to party, ladies and gentlemen.
That's what his shirt says. Let's have a party.
Let's have a party. Let's do it. Insane Dick Lane! Insane Dick Lane!
Looking over beers, ruining our business card.
The crowd chanting Dick. Insane Dick Lane. He is the meta-human supervillain. The crowd very much behind Dick Lane here.
Dick Lane has a utility belt.
Looks like we're gonna have a triple threat here, Harmon.
The terror has just entered the ring.
Killington? insane Dick Lane getting an amazing reaction here from the crowd.
If I had that kind of hair, I could get a reaction too.
Absolutely.
The crowd's already shouting, "We want Dick."
The crowd already sold on insane Dick Lane chanting, "We want Dick." I find that hilarious, awesome, and just downright disgusting.
Tony P, check all those pockets.
Tony P being very casual with a check down on insane Dick Lane. I feel like he's got something in those
in
pockets
that, in
there.
In that utility belt.
Insane Dick Lane from Dr. Cobblepot's laboratory. He weighs one megaton. I'm not sure if that's accurate, but Billington and Farva don't know what to do. Oh, my God.
Force choking them.
He's using the force, folks. Oh, not enough force, though. Billington and Farva just giving him the business right now. Through the ropes. Oh.
There is no padding out there.
No padding out there. Oh, Farva with a schoolboy. Only a two count on Billington. Oh, they're on two different levels here. Confused. They thought they were a cohesive unit. Not so much. Trading blows now. European uppercut. Side headlock now from Farva. Billington throws him into the ropes. Oh, leap over. Showing some athleticism for the big man.
Farva's built
like a
bowling ball.
Power slam. Into the corner now. Big splash from Farva onto Billington. That had to hurt. Farva's a big boy. Dick Lane back in the ring now.
Controlling this match right now.
Oh, a double splash from insane Dick Lane. Sends Farva into the other corner. Splash over to Farva. A splash to Billington. Billington screaming like a little girl. And a double clothesline, putting both men down. Armin Dick Lane is showing some ruthless aggression here. Oh, throwing the Haruka into Farva.
Oh,
the trip. Right.
Farva trips him right into the turnbuckle.
Farva too smart. Too smart.
That looked devastating. Dick Lane is getting manhandled right now.
Dick Lane's gonna bring out the superpowers, the super villain powers here. Oh, a super kick from Fat Boy Farva to Billington. Insiguri over to Dick Lane. Fat Boy Farva is dominating this match so far. Taking out both men at will.
No, he's hanging Dick Lane in the corner. Is this a tree of woe?
That's very good, Harmon. Wow. Uh-oh, getting the
solo cup
and the ping pong ball. Play a little Beirut here. Oh, no. Missed shot. The crowd is not loving it. Oh, just taunting him with props here. Billington takes punishment. Again, eats another super kick. Frat Boy Farva.
Dick Lane is still on the ground. Frat Boy Farva.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Crazy athleticism. What a bomb from Farva. What a big splash. That was impressive.
Amazing athleticism out of the big man.
Drags Dick Lane over. Insane Dick Lane trying to get out of it. He does so, bounces off the ropes, goes for a clothesline, misses. Oh, goes to the torture rack into a neck breaker. Torture rack.
That
to
could be
neck
it.
Breaker
that could be it.
Farva. Oh my goodness. Farber going up top. This could get dangerous.
Going up to the high rent district.
Not much clearance up there.
Oh, splash
from Farva.
That's got to be it.
Unbelievable. The two-pound Billington comes in to break it up. Farva and Billington going back at a headbutt from Farva.
Headbutt from the terror.
Wild miss by Billington.
Powerbomb!
Sit down. Powerbomb.
Only a two count.
Dick Lane over there in the corner trying to recuperate himself. Billington with a wild screech. Suplex to Dick Lane. And he is just going nuts.
Oh, he's choking him. Choking him. Ref, you gotta stop this. Man.
I think Terror John Billington rivals Grasa in the crazy category.
They probably share the same psychiatrist.
Dick Lane taking all kinds of punishment right now.
He's lost his headband, John.
Hope that's not where super villain powers come from, because he is out of luck. Oh, channeling some kind of energy. Got a choke going. Oh, not enough though. Not enough in the force there from Billington. Charging it again though. And he's got it this time. The crowd right behind him.
One more time. Let's see if he can get it done. He's got it. He's got him. Oh, right in the eyes.
Billington, crafty vet, using a crafty vet move with a rake to the eyes. Reversal here by Dick Lane, goes down. Oh, boot to the chest. Oh, and it's a cutter into a code breaker. I believe he calls that impending doom.
Farva saves the pin. He's still in this, folks. All three men have taken a beating.
Farva and Billington trying to work together again. Didn't work out so hot for him last time. Bouncing Dick off the ropes. He ducks under. Oh, double chokes. He's got him.
Oh, double choke slam.
Force choke slam. Using the force to do a double choke slam on both Billington and Farva. Dick Lane going for the pin. Billington kicks out. How did he kick out after that?
I don't know. How do you defeat magic?
Unbelievable display by Dick Lane using the force.
I love when that happens.
Dick Lane getting pushed back into the corner now by Billington. Billington pushed him up there on the top rope.
Farva back on the apron.
Farva doing. Oh, Farva eats a kick to the chest.
Knocks him back out of the ring. Dick Lane feeds a kick into the terror.
Oh, walking the ropes.
Oh, the cravat into the neck breaker.
Anti-life equation.
Dick Lane picks up the victory.
Anti-life equation onto Billington for the win. Insane Dick Lane getting high fives from kids.
The kids love him.
Amazing display.
This crowd loves him.
Amazing display of athleticism and
the
magic
force.
And the force. Amazing.
I have never seen anything like that, Johnny.
I've never seen anything like that. I'll say this, though. Barba showed amazing display of athleticism. He was a terror in that match. Him and Billington worked together at times, but it often did not work out in either of their favors. They oftentimes ended up
crawling back into the ring to give his buddy a hand.
Oh, a knee! Frat Boy Barba!
Oh, and a DDT!
Beating him a DDT! It is...
They are not friends anymore.
He is not the life of the party anymore, folks. It is party over for Billington. Unbelievable.
His night is over.
We've got Theodore J. Liftington. Look at this behemoth. Going with the leopard print trunks.
Strength and physical vitality.
Did you know that he's the master of 1,000 lifts? This Theodore J. Liftington. Claims to be the strongest man in the whole wide room.
I think he just broke the ref's hand. He's so strong.
I think so. He's going to have his hands full here with Jay George. Jay George, the unpredictable Jay George here, grabbing the mic. Oh, just singing. Singing his theme music. All good, Anthony Greene holding the disco ball. I've seen... Jay George not really getting the crowd reaction that he wanted, I think. I'm not sure this group of hipsters are really up to this song.
No, I don't think they're loving the 80s music.
No, they're... This crowd hasn't stopped listening to their Arcade Fire disc since 2006, so they don't know this song.
No, they have no clue. This is probably brand new to them.
Yeah. Theodore J. Liftington does not look impressed at all. He just wants to pick things up and put them down. He has no business dancing. Jay George just does not look like he's ready to wrestle. Looks like he's ready to go to karaoke night.
He's ready for a party. Theodore J. Liftington here is here for a fight. He is going to press him. He is going to lift him. He is going to drop him.
I'll say this, though. Jay George not getting this crowd reaction. They're actually turning on him pretty quickly right now.
It's probably his fantastic singing ability that's losing it for him.
They already don't like Anthony Greene, so I think that's part of his problem.
It was a poor choice for a disco ball holder. The crowd telling him what he can do.
Crowd politely asking him to stop singing.
Oh, this entrance needs to be over already.
This could have ended 3 minutes ago. I think Theodore Liftington is our only hope.
Oh no, he did not mention New Jersey.
Yeah, he just mentions New Jersey. So That's not going over well. Ring announcer pleading for him to stop. Crowd is getting very uninterested in J. George. Letting him know what they think of Jersey right now.
It's for the Sanctuary Live Stream Championship. It's been live streamed right now.
This match is being live streamed on the interwebs.
On the interwebs. Ever heard of it?
Look at the physique. He is a specimen.
He is a stout man. Look at him. He is a monster. Look at him.
From Newbridge, New Jersey.
Crowd giving just nothing but boos for New Jersey still.
Oh, the crowd is sour on J. George.
They do not like J. George. I'll say this, though. For what J. George is, man, he is a crafty vet. He's wrestled for Blitzkrieg Pro, Warriors of Wrestling, Combat Zone Wrestling, and Evolve. He is no slouch. If you think J. George is just nothing but disco ball and bad karaoke, you have another thing coming. That man can wrestle. And Theodore J. Liftington better be prepared for it.
Theodore J. Liftington, he's the strongest man in the whole wide room.
Absolutely. I do not believe it. Liftington asking for a gentleman's handshake. Oh, a test of strength. Haven't seen this since the old 80s. Liftington baiting him into a test of strength.
So far,
so good.
Oh,
Jay George just crying with pain.
Oh, just say mercy already.
Liftington doesn't even know his own strength, I think.
Liftington apologizing to the referee for the pain he's inflicting to J. George.
Oh, flip over.
Wow.
Liftington showing incredible strength. J. George is shocked at how strong Liftington is.
Just to be fair, everyone gets two tries. Everybody gets two tries.
Just like the carnival, folks. Everybody gets two tries.
Hey, George better think this one over. If I was him, I would not go for a second attempt. Oh, Jay George taking the cheap way out with a kick to the midsection. Liftington breaks the hold, bounces him off the ropes with a shoulder tackle right there, boom.
Didn't even move.
Two tries. Liftington cheering J. George on. Wants him to go for it again. And again, the same
result.
Doesn't
even budge. It's like running into a brick wall.
Absolutely. Liftington is in the house. J. George cannot match his strength. J. George getting the mic again. Liftington granting him one more try.
What a sport.
Ducking under is Liftington. Oh, a press.
Oh,
presses him over his head.
Flapjack.
Just right on the mat. J. George winds up, throws him in the corner.
J. George hit the corner with such force that he drove him out of the ring on the other side.
Jimmy George is just getting bounced around this ring. Flat right in the mat. Liffington is on fire right now. He hasn't even been touched.
I don't believe I've ever seen a competitor as strong as Theodore J. Liffington.
I've never seen him. Dancing on the ropes.
Catches him in midair. Oh!
Oh, Jay George reversing it, though. Liffington seems almost...
almost stunned.
Almost amused at that worked. Some slaps now. Slaps into the face of Liffington. Takes both his legs out. Oh, going for a swing, it
going
seems.
For a swing.
Jay George holding on.
George has a hold of his legs.
Oh, a headbutt from George. Armin, that is a ruthless move. Desperation doesn't even faze Liffington now.
Liffington's got him back up. Oh, couldn't hold him. Pushes George away.
Oh!
Spins him
around.
Slamming him down to the mat. With authority. Oh, only a two count.
Jay George.
It's a travesty.
Gets the shoulder up. You would think, however, if Liffington is so strong, he'll just hold him down, right? He's so strong. Jay George, though, crafty. He knows what he's doing in there. Oh! Cutter right on to the rope.
I'll take the wind right out of your sails.
Jay George doing the dog bark headbutt. Calling up the old junkyard dog move.
He sounds like a Pekingese.
Yep. Yeah, not so much junkyard dog, but tiny lap dog maybe.
The crane kick right in the mush.
Right in the mouth. Danielson would be proud. That crane kick. That's the same crane kick that knocked Johnny out of the tournament. Right to the mouth. My goodness.
That move worked in Karate Kid 1, 2, and 3, I
absolutely.
Believe.
Crowd still harping on New Jersey. It's their go-to right now. Jay George going for the suplex. Oh, boy.
Uh-oh. Liffington.
Look at the power of Liffington just holding him there.
All the blood is rushing to Jay George's face. Oh.
Suplex. Suplex to Jay George.
Jay George falling out of the ring right in front of us.
Liffington going to bring him back in. Still calling him his friend. What a gentleman. Going for the pin. And it's a two count. George gets his shoulder up. Oh, cheap
George.
Kick.
He's a kick to the back of his head.
Just getting desperate now with these strikes. Anything he can, any kind of offense he can muster, he's going to take it. Oh, a knee to the face of Liffington. Still not off his feet, though.
Oh, super kick.
Down to one knee. Another kick.
Liffington.
Liffington shaking it off, though. Oh my God, he's
hulking
up, though.
Three kicks in a row and he's standing.
A knee.
Another high knee.
How is Liffington taking this?
Oh, he just flexed at him.
Catches the fist.
Oh my God.
Spinning body slam. That looked deadly. Two count.
That should have been it. That should have been it. Where did Jay George get the strength and power out of that?
I don't know. It's just all instinct now for Jay George. Liffington sizing him up. Oh.
Wow.
Shoulder tackle. Just boom.
Wow.
Another one.
Look at those shoulder tackles. I'm getting run over by a truck.
Right into Liffington. Up goes Jay George.
Jay George, right
in Harmon's
right
lap.
In my lap.
Not going to get any protection. Jay George seeking out the only man that is maybe as big, maybe bigger than Liffington, my colleague, Big Bad Harmon.
Oh, Liffington suplex him back into the ring. Lifting
suplexes him in. Liptington going for the three count. Oh, only two out of it.
Oh, misses with the big elbow.
Big elbow with the whiff from Liptington. Jay George sizing him up, picks him up, picks the big man up. Oh, a body slam.
Going for the pin.
Oh, very close. Very close. Two count.
Lifting his shoulder up off the mat there.
Nice word play, my friend. Jay George playing to the crowd, desperately trying to get their approval. Oh, the super kick while he's down. Jay George backing himself into the corner. Oh, a running knee. His legs are under the ropes, though.
Referee official is telling him that
the official just doing his job. They're arguing over it now.
Oh, lost precious time there.
That could have been it, Harmon.
A pedigree
to Liptington. Jay George going up top now.
The second rope, he's grabbing the ceiling. Using the I-beam for support.
Swanton on to Liptington. And that's it. That is it for Theodore J. Liptington. Jay George takes home the victory over Liptington with a Swanton bomb from the beams. And the crowd is hating it.
Oh, he retains his title.
Liptington just on the ground. I cannot believe that. Jay George has the mic again. Nobody is digging the singing. He is exhausted and trying to sing, and the crowd is not liking it. Liptington over there recovering, though.
Slowly in the corner. Oh, people are throwing beer cans now at Jay George.
Oh, empty beer cans being thrown at Jay George. Liptington limping away. An amazing display of strength by Liptington, but sometimes it's not all strength. Jay George getting booed out of the arena here tonight. Getting beer cans and beer itself just thrown at him from the crowd.
Crowd wanting no part of any more Jay George.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think it's time for our main event of the evening.
Is it that time already, John? Who is this mountain of a man who just walked
Josh
out?
Josh Briggs.
Wow.
Look at the size of Josh Briggs, Harmon.
He is enormous.
He may be the only man taller than you right now in this building.
What is he, 6'6"?
Josh Briggs is 6'7".
Oh my God.
Weighing in at 269, he's an absolute monster.
269, not any of it fat. Leaping over the top rope.
Josh Briggs is a former D1 college football player at UMass. He's a three-year starter there. He is a bad, bad dude.
He is frightening.
He is a bad man, that Josh Briggs. His opponent, Ace Romero tonight. Speaking of bad man, Ace Romero is here.
hailing.
The crowd is loving Ace Romero.
Ace Romero hailing from our home state of Maine.
The crowd fully behind Ace Romero, getting high fives.
Ace Romero, a fan favorite wherever he goes.
Wherever he goes, Harmon, you said it.
AC Baby playing up to the crowd. Oh, Josh Briggs! Started this match off with a
Briggs
boot to the face.
Just immediately attacking Ace Romero. Not waiting for the bell, not waiting for the introductions. Ace,
oh my God!
Drop kick!
Did you see the ring shake?
Oh my God, Ace Romero already gonna fly early in this match. For a big man, he can fly, and he's going to right now. Through the ropes!
Oh my God!
Suicide dive through the ropes onto Josh Briggs. Ace Romero is fired up tonight.
Oh, Josh Briggs does not want a fired up Ace Romero.
He does not. Folks, if you've never seen Ace Romero, get ready for a treat. He can do it all.
Oh,
hard chops right to
devastating
Briggs.
Devastating chops from this man.
As bad of a man as Briggs is, Ace Romero can match it. Ace has got him on the outside, asking the crowd who wants to chop him. Oh,
a backhanded chop.
That's a fan, another fan. Oh, my God. Fans just chopping Briggs. Ace Romero doing the crowd a favor. Holding arms back.
Uh-oh.
Oh, big chop.
Oh, that sounded horrible.
Unbelievable.
I feel like that fan has done that before. Oh, they're calling for one more, I think.
I have never seen anything like this.
Oh, the crowd wants one more.
Crowd is demanding one more chop. Oh, no.
From the apron,
a big chop. Unbelievable.
Oh, Josh Briggs.
I almost feel bad for Josh Briggs.
Oh,
right
now. Across the tattoos.
Briggs has got to get some kind of offense going here. Another chop from Ace.
You could hear the wind leaving Josh Briggs' chest.
Asking the crowd for one more. Briggs just being the pincushion for Ace Romero right now. Taking chops left and right.
The crowd loving it. They're cheering for Ace to just not stop chopping him.
Ace getting a running start here. Briggs
moves
out of the way and guides him into the ring post.
Give me your chops.
Briggs mouthing off to the crowd after all those fan participation chops. Taking a swig
Briggs
of beer.
Stealing someone's beer,
spitting it on Ace Romero. The disrespect being shown.
Oh!
Dropping beer.
Oh, that's just heinous.
Unbelievable. Josh Briggs being the ultimate bad guy right now for this crowd.
He is not going to win any
not
points in this
liked.
Crowd.
Finally, they're getting in the ring. Briggs taking control now. European uppercut. Big boot to Ace Romero.
Ace is just hanging on the ropes, trying to get his bearings.
Mocking Ace Romero is Josh Briggs.
Oh, huge European uppercut in the corner.
Huge uppercut. Briggs welping him, the fans, to come in the ring.
Big boot to Ace.
Pushing him into the corner now. Showing that NCAA background here, football background. Just manhandling Ace. Ace pushing him back with a chop.
Right in the beard.
Another chop.
Oh.
A little forearm from Briggs. Knocks Ace down. Ace off his feet.
Checking his teeth. Make sure they're all still in his head.
The cover now. Two. Oh, one count. Not even a two. Just a one count. Briggs. Disapproval for the crowd's chanting here.
Singing Ace's song.
The crowd digs Ace's entrance music. Briggs, however, not so much. The crowd really getting under the skin of Briggs. He's, Harmon, he has to focus on Ace Romero. He cannot let this crowd get under
his skin. Too much time. Too much time.
That's what happens. That's what I'm talking about,
Harmon.
Firing
back with the chops.
Little rapid fire chops, little slaps from Ace Romero.
Fires Briggs into the corner.
Oh, and just a clothesline right in.
Back to the other corner.
Another one just following him right into the corner.
That's 320 pounds
of just mass
flying across the ring.
Ace Romero getting serious, taking off the shirt. Throws him into the corner. Oh, Ito, elbow on the way in, though.
Oh, Josh Briggs, pocket trash.
Spine buster. Hellacious spine buster.
Two
Only
count.
Only a two count. Josh Briggs writhing in pain. That spine buster was no joke.
See if he can even stand after that.
AC Baby stalking Briggs right now into the corner. Briggs breaks it, gives him an elbow of his own. Ace is not having it though, returns the favor. Ace is just, he looks like a rabid dog right now.
Foaming at the mouth.
Not gonna be able to move him that easily. Briggs trying to throw Ace in the corner. Does not happen. Ace does, though, to Briggs.
Reverse.
Falls it in with the elbow. Oh. Just a forearm shiver to the jaw.
I am God here.
Briggs. Briggs just eats another shiver. Ace to the other corner. Briggs comes in with a huge
boot. Briggs proclaiming that he is God. The crowd chanting that God is dead.
Ace grabs a tight.
Holding the trunks.
German, release German suplex.
Back into the corner.
Oh, no. Ace Romero sizing him up, folks. Goes in for the cannonball.
Oh, my God.
That is a large man to be doing a cannonball. Oh,
oh my
so
God!
Close. Two count. Josh Briggs just again writhing in pain, telling us how much it hurts. He
I
is
can
in
imagine.
Pain. He is taking a lot of punishment right now.
320 pounds just smashing into him in the corner. We'll have to scramble anybody's brains.
The crowd chanting AC Baby. Ace feeling it. He's hearing him. He's getting up to his feet. There he is, to his feet first. Josh Briggs still on the ground. What's Ace thinking? Ace pointing towards the
turnbuckle.
He's going
up top. Ace says he's
going to
kill him.
AC Baby going up top.
Oh, no.
The crowd.
Oh,
the ropes
no.
can barely hold them, folks. The crowd is in amazement. I am. I'm sure you are too, Harmon. Josh Briggs breaks up the momentum.
I am fearing for my life.
Oh, no, no. Josh Briggs going up top. This is going to get very dangerous, folks. Josh Briggs looking for a suplex, trying to suplex him back in. I don't know if this is possible, folks. Ace breaks it up, just slaps.
Shots to the ribs, knocking Josh Briggs back.
Just a front chop.
Briggs puts down, from the second rope, all the way across the ring. Ace is still climbing.
Ace has got to get up to the top. Belly to belly, oh my God! The ring just leapt up. Holy shit is right, folks. Can you believe that?
The impact caused our tiny little referee to bounce in the air as high as the top
belly
rope.
Belly to belly suplex from Briggs off the top. Of the pin. Two count. Two count.
That was devastating.
Oh, my goodness. I've never seen impact like that. Never seen impact like that.
Oh,
I am
God.
Still stunned. Ace reeling, finally getting to, he's on his knees now. Briggs to his
the crowd chanting
Briggs
for
to his
Ace.
Feet. Ace feeling the support of the crowd. Ace can barely stand using the ropes. Briggs sizing him up.
Ace.
Runs in, eats an elbow.
Ace with the foresight.
Missed by Ace.
Oh! Oh!
Pop up. Powerbomb. Only a two count. Ace. Ace with a cover. Ace with the arm. Two. Only a two count. The crowd cranting fight forever.
These two are just killing each other.
Ref begins the count, both men down. One of these men have to get back to their feet in order to win this. This would be a damn shame.
Ref's up to a five count.
If this was a draw, this would be a damn shame, Harmon. It can't end in a draw. One of them has to get up. They both look spent. It's a movement now. Ace.
Josh Briggs with elbows. Briggs with knees. Ace.
Ace
firing
returns
back
the favor.
Straight right hand.
Just fighting on their knees now. Briggs giving an FU and then a forearm. Ace returns, then Briggs. They are just beating the hell out of each other right now. A slap to the face from Ace, a forearm shiver from Briggs. Finally, both men to their feet now. Still just slugging it out.
Two giants in the middle of the ring just beating each other to death.
Just trading blows now. Ace getting the better of it. Spins around,
oh,
eats an elbow. Just eats an elbow from Briggs.
Briggs with a headbutt there.
Using that hard head of his. Ace, slow
oh.
drop on it, on the Briggs. Ace, Briggs asking to be hit.
Briggs is incensed.
Briggs is no stranger to being hit. He's an NCAA football player. He likes being hit.
Huge boot to the face.
Briggs just talking himself up now, pumping himself up.
Oh,
oh my God,
no.
Side slam from Ace Romero. That does it, folks. Sidewalk slam, reminiscent of the Big Boss Man, a sidewalk slam from Ace
Romero. Gets the win.
Gets the win. He wins the main event here tonight at Live Pro Wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, Ace Romero, incredible showing, defeating Josh Briggs.
Unbelievable. These two guys just killed each other.
Josh
Briggs was just asking for it, wanted more, and he got all he could handle today
Josh
with Ace
Briggs,
Romero.
Yeah. He bit off way more than he could chew in that meal. AC Baby bringing it. Much to the crowd's delight, Ace Romero going out on top tonight.
Unbelievable main event, Johnny. Unbelievable main event, Johnny.
Unbelievable. Providence, Rhode Island loves Ace Romero. And they love chopping the shit out of Josh Briggs. Ace showing some respect to the young Josh Briggs. Showing respect, trying to get the crowd behind him.
Trying to get the band to stop playing.
He's extending his hand. It's called sportsmanship, says Ace Romero.
Let's see if Josh Briggs obliges.
Josh Briggs.
He does. Oh, and he kicks Ace.
A low blow. Come on, boy.
I can't believe he did that. What a jerk.
I can't believe it. Ace Romero, being a classy wrestler he is, showing Josh Briggs respect. A man that he just beat, showing his respect, extending his hand, and Josh Briggs low blows him.
I can't believe it.
Unbelievable.
What a classless display by Josh Briggs.
You know, as big as Josh Briggs, as big and powerful and as talented as he is, he's got a bright future ahead of him, but he has to learn some respect, especially for a guy like Ace who's been around the block a few times. Oh, Ace Romero getting up now, though.
Oh! Ace Romero firing out of the corner, hitting Josh Briggs with a lariat, turning him inside out.
Acey Baby, total redemption, much to the crowd's delight.
That'll teach ya.
Well, Harmon, it was a blockbuster night here at Live Prob Wrestling.
What a show.
What a show. I tell you, folks, if you're anywhere near Providence next time Live Prob Wrestling is on, you have to come out. This has been quite an experience.
I won't forget it.
Nor will I. All right, folks, that's the show. You guys can follow Live Prob Wrestling on Facebook at Live Prob Wrestling. Check them out there. This has been a whole lot of fun. Harmon, for Big Bad Harmon, I'm Johnny Fashion. We are the Main Event Podcast. Catch you guys later.
Good night.